of you. How did you find the vendors you found, and what were the best ways for them to reach out to you? I mean, if it's so, why don't we start that way? Okay, just like think about some of the vendors that you have, or have booked, or you're looking for, and how did you find them?
A lot of our stuff, you know, we try to start with the big stuff, so we went, and I knew what I wanted. I wanted a country barn, laid back kind of wedding. And I lucked out because I had a friend out in Winston that's an event planner for Wake Forest, and they had done events at Wemmock, and she knew I wanted it in a barn and all that kind of stuff. And I had looked up online, you know, barns around the area, but she sold me on this place. We went and looked at one other place, but after going to Wemmock, it was just meant to be, and that's what we did. And from there, you know, they had their recommended list of caterers, so I talked to every single one on that list, and we met with a couple of them, and we went with Visions Catering, which it just, everything was right, the package, the price, all that, and I mean, they were great. And the biggest thing about everybody that we booked was they made me feel like they were really there for us. You know, we met other people that it just kind of seemed like they wanted your business. Like they didn't, I mean, I knew they cared, but these people made me feel like they were there for me and they wanted it to be perfect. And if it wasn't, they weren't happy. So that was the big thing for us. And then next we met, Billy Buskirk was our photographer. And I actually met her at a bridal show. And the photographer was like the biggest thing for me, because that's what you have for the rest of your life are the pictures. And I was stressed out about that because I didn't know where to go. I had people recommending people left and right, and it was like, that's a hard thing to tell. And when we first met Billy, I liked her right away. We left the bridal show and it was like, I really liked her. And we had talked to other people, but nobody made me feel like she did, because you can tell right off the bat that she loves what she does, and she wanted me to be happy, and she was as excited as I was about everything. So that was a easy decision once we went with her, and everything just seemed to fall into place. Like anybody we talked to, it was, you just knew once you talked to those people how they made you feel, and they made me feel special, and that's what I wanted.
That's right. It's all about you.
That's right.
That's good. That's good. You know, it's good when they get that, too.
Yeah.
Because it really is.
Mm-hmm.
Good. Thank you, Sabina.
Since my wedding is so far out, we just got engaged April 4th. Thank you. we haven't had a chance to do a whole lot, but we're trying to get everything done this summer. And so far, I've been able to actually found my church yesterday, and we booked our reception site with Miss Rebecca Foley over there. I'm very excited. And finding a reception site was actually very difficult as far as just staying with budget and having someone that seemed really interested in helping me out, and she did a really good job, so I was very excited about that. And as far as other vendors go, I went to the Castle McCullough Bridal Show a week or two ago, and what stood out a lot about a lot of vendors were most of them were walking around and trying to get our attention towards their booths, and then there were others that were kind of busy talking with themselves. So the ones that were really reaching out to talk to us really drew us in, and still continuing to look for pretty much everything else.
That's good. And that's where I met you.
Yes.
Okay. Carly?
Well, I attended several bridal shows with and without my daughter, and it mainly comes down to a process of elimination and personalities that match. We had to find a venue that could handle a large amount of people, and our church fellowship hall was not that place. And my daughter wanted something that part of the event could be outside, and so Pine Lake was her first choice, and that's how we ended up there. And I realized quickly that there was no way that anyone else other than Jennifer could handle that day. We had a ceremony director, and she was very efficient, but to put the ceremony and the reception for over 300 people on one person is much too much. So although we did have a lot of friends helping, even the day of the event, the decorations were made by friends, and that was for over 30 tables, and much of it was done ahead of time, but it still took them, with a team of, I think, 8 people, it took them about 4 hours to set up. So you really need to delegate, and you need to do that ahead of time and ask people, you know, when someone says, I'm willing to help, tell me whatever, write their name down on a list, because you're gonna need them. You are going to need them. And at first you'd think, well, what would she be good at, or what could I ask them to do? But it all falls into place. I mean, we've had people parking cars. They ended up changing a tire for a woman, you know, and just people greeting because we couldn't be there. We were doing pictures, and you just have to think ahead of what you can do. And it was, Pine Lake was a beautiful place for it. It was a gorgeous day, and we had cornhole games, 8 of them set up, and croquet, and wine barrels around. And so the people had something to do when they arrived. For music, I think the two main things you need to be concerned about for the reception, outside of where you have it, is the food and the music. Because the music comes in a quick second to the food. You want the food to be wonderful. You want to start with something fun. We had gourmet popcorn and sweet tea and lemonade when they arrived, and they could go outside or whatever, or sit and visit. And we had acoustical guitar, a family friend who's very good, and he played for 45 minutes. And then we had easy listening during the reception and so on. But we used Culinary Visions out of Greensboro, and it was the best wedding food that anybody had ever had. It was wonderful. And they were also very, very giving in their time and, you know, making the menu what we wanted it to be and so on. So they were wonderful. And you work through it and pray that every week you make progress until you get there.
Well, my biggest thing is reaching out to other vendors. I actually did event wedding planning for 6.5 years in Massachusetts, so I'm kind of familiar with the business, although when you're a bride, everything changes. we were very blessed to be able to have the ceremony at the church that my fiance and I both joined together not too long ago. And for as far as location was concerned, getting engaged just in April and then wanting to get married later this year, I was well aware that Saturdays might have been a challenge, so we were willing to look at Fridays and Sundays. We're also working on a budget. We have some help, but paying for a lot of the rest of it ourselves. So, of course, wanting a very nice, elegant wedding without completely going into debt and breaking the bank, which I think is a lot of brides' concerns. So we were willing to do another night during the week, and we were very blessed. Also doing event wedding planning for a hotel and catering company, I wanted something that was a little bit different than what it was I had planned for other brides for so long. So we looked at a few wedding facilities. My fiance had also been married before, so we wanted something a little bit different than his first wedding. So we settled on Revolution Mill. I walked into there, we both walked in, and we said, yep, this is it. Because it was very different than anything I had been involved with before. And it was gorgeous, very elegant. You don't need a lot of decorations there. And it fit with my fiance as well, who's very like architectural design kind of guy. So. We're really excited about that, and they happen to have one Saturday left, which we booked that, so I was really excited about that. We have a good amount of out-of-town guests coming in because my family's all from Massachusetts, And so we're working right now on finding, you know, hotel accommodations that are easily to get to for both Westover Church and Revolution Mill. We do have our rehearsal dinner booked, but I'm, of course, looking for a photographer. I share the same concerns with photographers because you don't know. And it's, you know, I guess just getting to know the person. Go for it. As a Mary Kay person, we just automatically go like this when the camera goes out. So I'm looking for, you know, obviously a good photographer. I am working with a very good friend of mine who is a caterer here in Greensboro. His name is Alan Thigpen, and we're working with him. What I love about working with vendors is really knowing, again, that they have a passion for this and that they do pour their heart and soul into your day. And you know that once you book them, you don't have to worry about it again. And that's a really big thing for me. I'm very busy. My fiance is very busy. My mother's in Massachusetts, who's very helpful, but she's there. And my maid of honor is here, and she's wonderful. But, you know, it's as being the bride, you want to have a little bit of a handle on things. So just really knowing as a vendor, allowing that bride to really know that you're there for her, settling her nerves and saying, you know what, I got this. I promise I understand where you're coming from, what you're looking for, really knowing what she's looking for and then setting her at ease. Did I answer all the questions?
Yes.
Okay.